Locate 24 volt supply and laser printer diagnostic manual, which will feed our mini DC motor and our Arduino. We will LM7805 5 volt regulate this down to 5 volts and are using this instead of the 5 volt line, just in case the motor would pull too many amps from the 5 volt line, which was only designed to power the logic of the printer, not the motors. Okay, so let's try to find that then. That's the first step on my to-do list for my printer repair project, where we are creating an Arduino-based workaround power assist system that will aid in turning the pickup roller, which just needs a little bit of extra oomph to get it turning. And that's the solution we chose instead of replacing the weakened magnetic clutch for the pickup roller, which is located deep inside the gear assembly area and would require a tremendous amount of additional taking apart the printer. And I was not liking the huge buildup of parts scattered throughout my house, where something could get broken or lost so easily. And the more stuff you take apart, the more risk that you're not going to be able to figure out how to put it back together properly and might break something. And I know that my viewers were also getting concerned for that. The more taken apart that thing looked, the more they were convinced that that thing's done. It's broken forever, because it becomes an overwhelming job to try to put it back together once the complexity of having tons of scattered parts everywhere that may or may not be labeled just falling off tables and getting lost, it's just a nightmare, the more taken apart it becomes. So we did not want to go any further than we had to with disassembly, because I mean, look at this part blow up drawing. Just look at all these parts, a million parts there. I mean, we're looking at list parts, a million more parts. And then a million kazillion more parts. We don't want to be taking all that apart, man. That's a nightmare. We don't want this fix to be a freaking 6-month project. Look at all these parts. I'm trying to keep this thing reasonable. That's all. Parts galore. What we're looking for, though, is a drawing schematic of the electrical PCB. We're looking to find the 24 volt input line coming off the power supply and feeding into the main brain's DC controller PCB. We want 24 volts from that. The 24 volts can feed directly into the Arduino, which has built-in voltage regulation, which will bump it down to 5 volts. It has an onboard regulator, as well as all the necessary supporting capacitors that go with the regulator. When I made a homemade Arduino, I had to build my own regulator. But since I'm using a pre-built Arduino, I don't have to worry about it. Okay, this is the power supply unit, and main wiring 2 of 2. Alright guys, J134 looks like our 24 volts and ground. And it's got several 24 volt rails so that it can run more amps. J134 is the name of the connection on the DC controller PCB. J402 is the name of the connection on the power supply unit. So this is where the power supply unit sends the 24 volts. It also sends a 5 and a 3.3 with their corresponding grounds. And a bunch of other stuff I don't know what it means. ZLD? We're interested in the 24 volts and ground. So, J134. We could pull from pin 8 and pin 1 if we want, I guess. All the grounds are the same. All the 24s are the same. So 8 and 1 will be a nice spread apart way to do it, I guess. What about my desk? J134. You know what? I think now would be a good time just to shut it off, actually. So I'm gonna shut it off. Okay, printer is off. Yes, it's my bedroom. This technology is not outdated. Show me a laser printer that has better technology than this laser printer. You're implying that laser printers are better than they used to be. This laser printer is no less than any modern day laser printer. They're the same technology. It's not outdated if it hasn't changed or been improved upon. Perhaps computers can become outdated because their job is to process and processors can get faster and blah blah blah, but that's not the case with the laser printer whose only job is to print. And this thing prints with just as high a resolution as any printer. I challenge you to find a laser printer that's better. Alright, J134. Right now I'm fixing my 3D print, or my laser printer. That has nothing to do with my robotics projects or anything, but it's requiring overlapping skills. Haha, J134! I found it, boys! I found it. It's this red one right here. Let me show you guys. These red ones here. You can see it says it right there. No, you guys can't see it. It was under it or something. You can't see the lettering, but it's that one, bottom right corner. Boom. All right, so we have located the 24 volt input group. Now I don't know which ones are ground because they're all colored red. We know that half of them are ground, the other half are 24. We can just do our splicing right off, and then after we've cut into them and spliced, we can get it powered back up and choose a color later on. We could just send it as red on both of them anyways. Since they're doing all red, I can copy. I don't need to commit to anything. All we're going to be doing is running the wire off of this line down through the wiring harness all the way around and then up and then over and meeting it back out here where the Arduino is going to be and where our motor is going to be that helps out the pickup roller assembly. Wonder if there's some way to determine which side is ground and which side is voltage. Oh, look, they have a 1 and an 8. Drawn on the board, which helps you with pins 1 through 8. So pin 1 is ground, pin 8 is 24 volts. Beautiful! So the leftmost one is ground. We can come off that with black. That's really useful. Man, that's so cool. I'm glad I checked. They just put a little 1 and a little 8. Normally you wouldn't think twice about it, but I just happen to remember it's labeled pins 1 through pin 8. And so putting a 1 and 8 just tells you which side is which, looking at it. I haven't officially started programming the robot because I'm planning to build it first and then program its capabilities. But I do have a ton of code that I can reuse from other projects, such as a video game bot I coded. So a lot of the basic principles and algorithms can definitely cross over. And a ground is the return line on any DC, so like a battery has a positive and ground. If you look at a AA battery, the nipple side is the positive and the flat side is the ground. So it's just the place where the power comes back into the source. Label all important components inside the printer and all important wires inside the printer and all important components of our project itself using post-it notes and packing tape, which will be preliminary, and we will label anything added at the end as well. Beautiful. I'm down. Yeah, I think that's a great idea. It's a pain in the butt. However, it will help a lot. So I don't have to relearn all this years later if I open this thing up again. It'd be funny if I never opened it up again. It's just labeled randomly and thrown in the garbage anyways, but I think it's just good practice to label things. So this is a lot of extra work, but guys, I'm telling you, it saves so much time later on by you not having to learn what the heck you're looking at ever again. I think that labeling things is huge for later. It's like documenting your code. It's documenting things that are tangible. You always want to write code comments, right? Labeling what the code's doing and stuff. And I think the same thing should apply. And it'd be stupid not to apply it to electronics. I really do. And it's something that is a pain in the butt, just like code comments, but it saves you when you go back into things to troubleshoot. You don't have to relearn everything from the ground up, spending countless hours. Everything's just labeled with notes. These are like little visual notes. Hey, that went pretty well. I know nobody else is going to agree with this, but all right, number one. Oh, okay. Pin one. No, pin eight is 24 volts. Okay, so that's on the right. My name is Larry. I'm from Tibet. Pin 8 is 24 volts, okay. Just double checking. Before something gets blown up. For the millionth time, I think it's good to live with your parents for your whole life. Until they die, of course. You get lots of free stuff and save a lot of money. And, you get free babysitters once you start having kids, which is nice. Holy cow. You know, this is totally worth it, though. Alright guys, so we got our first group of labels in. We got our, hold on. So this part here, we labeled it. Registration magnetic clutch. I labeled the wires going into it. And then here, 24 volt ground and 24 volts. So we labeled that, and now we know what's going on if we ever have to open this up again. So I'm documenting my project, documenting critical components only, not every little thing, but like things relevant to like what I learned and what I've been working with on this project specifically. My wife, does she hate you? No. But she doesn't like that sometimes you guys seem a little disrespectful toward me. Sometimes she laughs at stuff that you guys say. Sometimes she feels you cross the line. But that's her lack of confidence in me. If she knew what I knew, she could laugh along when people make fun of me because I know that you guys don't realize you're laughing at the modern day Leonardo da Vinci. Oh. Gotta be kidding me. Yeah, boy. Okay, so now we got this yellow wire labeled. I don't get it. Pickup roller brakes release latch solenoid. So we got the wire labeled. And that's just how we're doing it. I don't even have that many more, and this makes a huge difference. I did four labels, and already it's like, I don't know, it makes this whole thing look less intimidating. Seeing my handwriting, my little labels, it makes me have some feeling of like ownership, like I own this printer, and I understand it, and I labeled it, and I know where all the major things are going, and it's kind of like, this is a point of interest to be aware of, and it's just great. I love this. I want to do this for all of my projects. Just label everything. Why not work more comfortably? Well, I mean, you got to consider my whole setup. I have a space heater right here. And I have a bucket to put my legs on like this. So I can cross my legs comfortably. I have a comfy office chair I'm pretty much laying down in with a pillow behind my head. So that's pretty comfortable. I'm like laying down right now. And then I got my computer with my chat on it and a face cam on it and my mouse here so I can use that computer. I also have voice control so I can control it. And then off to the right, I've got my table with what I'm working on. Normally I work over my lap. But this printer weighs like 200 pounds, so it's unrealistic to do that. So I created a table setup where two legs hit the ground, but then the other end of the table has no legs. It's just going over my bed. It's like overlapping onto my bed. And then I put a iced tea container under it to make it level. And a little plastic box. So I just kind of shimmed it up. So now it's a level table. And to work on it, I just need to lean over like that. But most of the day, I don't want to work on it. So it just sits there. And yet, it's not too much in my way that I can't sit here and do my thing. But so it's kind of inconvenient taking up some of my workspace here. And it's kind of inconvenient taking up some of my sleeping space there. But it's not taking up all of either. So it's kind of in the middle of inconvenience and non-inconvenience. But it's perfectly located for me to work on stuff. So it's actually a really good setup, all things considered. Otherwise, I'd have to go set up a stream in some other room, on some other table or whatever. I don't want to do that. Like, I have my whole stream set up here. Not to mention, I have this fully adjustable boom arm lamp with webcam, which I can't just move anywhere. It's got a whole hinge system. It's all set up here. So it would be very unideal to move to a whole new location. I have to set up all the cameras and set up computers and everything. But I fail to see how I'm not looking comfortable. I'm pretty much laying down. This is a very ergonomic setup. Only when I have to like lean over here to work on it am I a little bit uncomfortable, but it's a good ab workout. And that's very temporary. When I look back at my monitor or work over myself, I can be completely comfortable again. I think I'm getting faster. All right, here's my latest label. Let me get this. It has to do with my light. Pickup roller, brakes release, latch solenoid. So I labeled the wire right outside of it. And I think all these labels are really going to help out. I think they're a great practice. Alright, what else would I want to label? I mean, that mainly covers it. Honestly, I'm pretty happy with that. That didn't take that long. You guys act like it's the end of the world seeing me label a couple parts. Big frickin' deal. We're gonna be doing a lot more work than that on this thing. That's the least of our worries. And yet, it makes coming back to the project later so much faster. We can pretty much just look around and see all the major components and get our memory jolted on what's going on very quickly. The whole point of documenting and note-taking and like commenting out code is to help your future self. Of course, it's inconvenient for your present self, it's your future self will thank you. All right, be right back. All right, so to make a splice with two wires, you take the first set of wire and you cut away a section of insulation, exposing bare copper. Then you take the second wire, you cut and strip it, and you place it parallel with that first wire, and you wrap it around it a little bit. And then you take a male or female DuPont connector crimp fitting, just the copper fitting, and you line it up and you crimp it over the two wires, solidly mechanically connecting them, and then you also crimp it over their two insulations. And so that will create a sound mechanical fitting without any soldering, which introduces thermal stress and other problems such as brittle points that fail pretty quickly. So this is a really good way, I think, to splice into wire without harming the original wire you're splicing off of by cutting it in any way or just removing some of its insulation. That's it. And then you're going to re-insulate it anyways with electrical tape. So that's how I'm going to do it. This is thrilling. Game-changing. I'm telling you that soldering is introducing thermal stress to the wire, makes the wire brittle, and is very prone to failure, as well as solder travel over time. It creates thermal stress. It creates a hard point where the rest of the wire is very flexible. And it is never used for those reasons. It's introducing dangerous weaknesses. It's poor practice. You will never see soldered wire in any appliance or robotics project. Or any electronic handheld device or anything like that. It sucks because I have to do this all left-handed too, and one-handed. It makes it a real challenge. Goodness. Oh, if I could only use my right hand. Maybe I have to sit up for this, bend in, get my right hand involved. Okay. All right, I'm carving it now. We're getting it, little by little. Oh, I don't think you guys can see that well. You know what? I got a better idea. What if I put this webcam onto this lamp? I see copper. And I don't mean a police officer. Trying to keep my knife always parallel to the copper so we don't score it or weaken it at all. Hey, I know what I need. My magnification. That really helps when you can see really, really clear. A little nap never hurts. Nice regroup. And now we can get back into it. tell you what, I think it would be easier to pull this connector off. Oof. Ah! The heck? Why won't it come off? Shoot! You know what? I'm over it, man. I'm leaving this stupid thing on. Pinch my fingers in the stupid needle nose two or three times. It's gonna leave a mark. Oh, you know what? I can check behind it with my dental mirror. Forgot about that. This dental mirror I'm using all the time, I'm finding. Okay, that is perfectly stripped. Now, we want to pull a jumper wire off it, super long, and we need it to be black. And we want to crimp fit it on. Wonder if I can strip this with my new stripper. Nailed it. Wow. Good job, little stripper. Not bad at all. Still gotta clean it up a little bit. Perfect. Okay. Alright, so now we got a little bit of copper exposed here. And we want to splice off of this line. Without soldering. Maybe using this crimper. Don't they say to do the insulation first? Thank you.
Huh, just occurred to me a different way to look at this thing.
Alright, I am going to do a little bit of soldering in addition to the crimp fitting. So here's what we got so far. So we put a male crimp fitting onto this wire. We're gonna solder the joint because I didn't pinch it very well. Maybe I could pinch it better though. Huh. Wrong way. Okay. You know what, we might be good.
Wow.
I mean, that's a great fitting right there. Wow. It's super, super solid now. I mean, this insulation part is a little off, but it's solid. And that's a male, so I could just connect a female easily. Which I have, and I will get. I want a black female. A thick black female. Wire. Okay. Look at that. We are officially spliced, baby. Look at that. Alright. That's a nice Y fitting right there. I did not say I want a long member! Maybe that's all? I don't know. So, we finished taping off this joint. I can show you the taped off version. There we go, so it's now Y-ing off. Originally, this red wire came up and over, and it's still intact, but I just stripped away some insulation, and I crimp fitted on a crimp fitting, and then I put a male into that, and it's all taped off now. Well, you can see the little test point on this male jumper. I think you can. It's right here. I don't know. You'd have to catch a glimmer from it. But, yeah, that's a jumper cable we forked off of the ground line. 24-volt ground. And I already sent this jumper cable now. Down and through underneath that, and then underneath that, and then up, and it's now in the air. So we put it into the harness, in other words, and now it's coming to here. And so it's forking off of there, coming around under and to here. We're going to bring it all the way to the front of the machine. That 24 volt line that we're forking from, this is a ground part of it. It's not colored appropriately, but the four to the left, the first four pins are ground, and the right four pins are 24 volts. And I labeled it, so we don't forget. This came right off the instruction manual, so I know. And I labeled this one as ground. You know what? I'll put the ground label in the front. so we can read it. There. 24 volt ground and 24 volts. Everything's labeled, everything's good to go, and we forked off the ground line already. You can see the fork. So now we have to fork off the 24 volt line next. We'll use the same technique because I think it worked well, and I don't have any better ideas for how to do it at this time.
I'm carving away the insulation. This 24 volt line is going to power our Arduino and our DC motor, which is going to power assist the pickup roller turning.
No, it won't fail eventually because my power assist is more than really a power assist. It's actually going to be strong enough to do the entire pickup roller turning without even the help of the weakened pickup roller. So my power assist can actually power it alone. Even if the magnetic clutch completely fails over time. So my system is a permanent fix, not a temporary fix. I think you guys can't see what I'm doing. That's not good. Maybe they heard that.
Okay,
let me start over. That went very poorly.
Good grief.
Alright, I give up on that. I tore it up too much now. I can't continue trying that. It was just really hard to begin with, but now it's impossible. So I'm just gonna send... send this male jumper as a replacement. This will help to heal all that wiring too. Turn this on, turn that down. That's fine. What am I doing? I am fixing my printer. Mm-mm-mm-mm-mm-mm.
Alright, solder to save the day. When crimp connections fail, solder me up, boys.
I'm gonna support the hell out of that joint, that's for sure. I'll show you guys the finished joint here. One solder joint is not going to cause cancer. It's if you're doing it all the time without proper ventilation. And I have a ventilation system running in this room, actually. I could also use a crosswind ventilation system with the charcoal filter, but I don't have that set up right now. Because it's just for one joint, it wouldn't be worth setting all that up. Okay. Now I need mail. Red. Here. Boom. Taping off each connection with tape so it doesn't accidentally unplug. And it's good practice. Also, I read to keep corrosion out of the connection. For robotics. Technically, this isn't robotics, but technically, it is also robotics. It is and it isn't. Boop-a-doop-doo. Okay. Alright guys, so the only thing I need to do now is on the two wires I sent off from the main brain's DC controller PCB, which we're going to use to wire our Arduino and our motor for our power assist mechanism on the pickup roller assembly in the front of the printer. We just need to write on those wires 2TO Arduino. And that will be a way of marking both ends of every wire, indicating where it's coming from and where it's going and why. So it's almost like documenting your wiring visually on the wires itself and on the parts themselves, labeling things. I think it's a great practice to get in the habit of, to make it easy to find out what's going on and understand everything you are doing and what you're thinking. And after that, we get to put the outer laser assembly board back on. Then we can put on the back panel too. So things are really coming along. We're going to be having things getting put away before you know it. Alright, so here's what I put on that one. Two Arduino pickup roller assist system, and it's labeled 24 volts. And it's red, so that's also color coordinated. So that tells me what this random red wire that's coming off the main brain's DC controller is doing and why. And it's saying it's for the pickup roller assist system. So if somebody were to ever open this thing up and try to understand what's going on and what mods I made, they would see very easily exactly what I did and why, where it's going. So I feel that that's just a great way of documenting. Alright, I'm putting in the four screws for this laser PCB. I got all the cables plugged in and rerouted how they were originally, just about, maybe slightly off, but pretty well routed. This is my laser printer I'm fixing. Am I almost done? No, but I'm done accessing certain areas, which I'm buttoning back up, putting the panels back on, remounting everything, rerouting everything back to how it was stock. We did what we needed to do inside of these areas. Yeah, I guess it is pretty complicated, but everything gets simple if you spend enough time with it and study it for a long time and know what's going on. I've been working on this thing for weeks, so I'm very well acquainted with it. Hi, Zadrun. Alright guys, so I just put on this back panel. This left part here that covers the USB and the whatever, this panel here. I just snapped it back on. It all looks pretty good. It's all like stock back here now, for the most part. Back right cover's next then. To go back on. I can take this back too. Always forget to turn the scene back. Okay. Here it is. What the hell just fell? Sorry for the violent outburst. That's just really frustrating. I just heard something loudly crash, and I barely touched anything. Was that door thing, a fuser door. Got it. What is wrong with the printer? This is called the pickup roller, and the pickup roller has to turn to grab the first paper off a stack of papers. And it never turned. It stopped turning. So, no paper would ever get picked up. And that meant... the printer would just say there was a paper jam in the tray. Because it thought there must be a jam since no papers are coming in. But the truth of the matter was that a magnetic clutch had too weak of a magnetic field to carry enough torque to the pickup roller to turn the pickup roller to grab the first paper. So I'm creating a power assist mechanism using an Arduino and a mini motor to turn this pickup roller at the appropriate time and make it actually work. The only advice a video like that would say to somebody like me is send your printer to a repair facility where you will pay more than the price of a new printer to get it fixed, and you are not covered under warranty. Ha! Ha! No, this printer is far from broken, but there are some issues with the pickup tray, which got broken when I stuck my knee on it, and it cracked a bunch of plastic in half, and all kinds of stuff happened. So I will be modding all of that, as well as fixing this issue with the pickup roller not being able to turn anymore. So those are separate matters, all requiring attention, though. Okay. We need to build out. We need to build out this whole face because this little arm that snaps into it right here barely is even in it. I don't know what changed, but when I put my knee on this tray and busted it off, things changed. We'll leave it at that. So this thing needs to be brought out substantially. And in order to bring it out, I'm planning just to build it up all around here with epoxy putty. So I'm going to just score it really good. Giving the epoxy putty a larger surface area to bite into. Cross-hatching the scoring now. Alright, I'll show you the scoring we did here. I think this is a very important part of a successful bond. There we go. So that whole front face is all scored thoroughly. You can see that this little arm is barely in here. It's barely in here. So I'm bringing this wall out so that that arm seats well into it. And I'm sure this will work. Well, I'm not sure. I'm pretty sure. I mean, you never really know unless you've done something before. Which is rarely the case for me, and I'm glad for it because that means I'm constantly learning if I'm never doing anything twice. Except square cutting. That I do a lot. Okay.
Alright, that box is on Krusty. Let me get the piece on here. Oh no. Thanks, guys, take it away. Need to see the police again. Ouch. Yes, got him. Okay. Not that close.
Yeah, we.
Max, 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 Max,
no.
It's a mess up. Check my way. Shh. Smoker boys. Hey. 80% of the way through the prototype for the robot's power supply. I'm currently under all my own projects. I'm going to call in a laser pointer. Hurry in the hands. Very smart actually, guys.
Beautiful! Okay, let me clean up and reset because we finished that. Oh yeah, we finished that. Beautiful! Man, am I pleased. Alright, so I'm just going to clean up, put everything away, full reset. I like to do these resets between jobs.